it's very interesting to see how people respond to this material once you tell them it is made out of fungus.
My initial reaction was, I've never heard of anything like it. Never heard of natural insulation.
Pink board or blue board that we use for insulation is typically made out of oil-derived polymers that are non-biodegradable. They cost a lot to produce.
So we use sawdust and natural materials, and we add some fungus culture to it, and it grows.
The fungi has a scaffold that allows for structural integrity, and it allows us to create blocks of insulation within a week. The first question we always get, is this going to kill me if I touch it? It is fungus, but it's not toxic. It's not going to jump on you and try to take over your body. We started off by testing different species to see which ones would produce a foam-like substance that traps air, but also has a skin that sheds the moisture. The next phase we are working on right now is testing for the biomaterial's behavior in fire. We are also looking at water absorption and how well this material will perform under freeze thaw cycles. In this project, we really focus on bringing environmental health, biotechnology, and local knowledge together to bear on the problem when styrofoam and other foams get broken down in the environment. We call it biomaterial because it's biological material. We do not have like a great name that we came up with, so crowdsourcing may be the way to do it.
Two weeks you'll be working with sea lions. Next thing you know, it's sea otters. You'll be doing a bird survey. You can work for the Department of Energy. Everybody that comes out here, they're very passionate about what they want to do, and they only have 2 weeks to do it.